Hi, I'm Ahmad Shah. So you want to become an aircraft engineer?
Okay, to become an aircraft engineer, what you need is an aircraft maintenance engineer license, which you can get from your own country's civil aviation authority. So in my case, I am a Malaysian, so I have to go for examination with the civil aviation authority of Malaysia. If you want to become an aircraft engineer, you don't go and take the license yourself. Even though you have the money to do it, your father is rich, parents is rich, no. Make sure you enter a program that is under the airline. It's the same if you want to become a pilot. You don't go to pilot school and get your own license even though you have the money. No. You make sure you enroll into an airline program, an airline cadet pilot program. It's the same as aircraft engineer program. Make sure you enroll under an airline because usually after you have finished your studies, the airline will straight away take you in. An aircraft engineer is the one who maintains the aircraft. So by maintaining, I can give you an example, your car. So if you have a car or you have a motorbike, every 5,000 kilometers, you need to get the car or the motorbike to the workshop to get it serviced. So the same with aircraft. So aircraft, after a certain flying hours, they need to go into a hangar. A hangar is a place where they maintain aircraft. So there are certain checks that you need to do. There's a checklist that you have to check on the aircraft. So we as the aircraft engineers make sure that all the things that need to be checked are checked and is good. If it is not good, then we have to replace it or service it. And then when all the checks are done, then we are the ones who certify that the aircraft is fit to fly again. For my field, there are two types of engineers. One is the hangar engineer, the one that I told you before. The one who do all the checks when the aircraft is due for service, you can call it. And the other one is engineer at the airport. So the one in the hangar, they work office hours. So you can say office hours, 5 days a week, 8:30 to 5:30, around there. But for the engineers that is at the airport, they work on shift patterns. 24/7, you have to have an engineer there standing by at the aircraft. So depending on the company you work for, the shift pattern might be different. So, but it is a shift job. You have to work day and night. Don't expect a 9-to-5 job. Because even if you were to work in the hangar, sometimes your boss will need you to be there during night shift. Because they will sometimes they run 24 hours operation if they have lots of work to be done and they have time constraints. The job market is actually quite saturated right now. So now is not a good time to enter, but if you have the opportunity then, and if you are passionate about it, then why not? In Malaysia, there are only Malaysia Airlines, Malindo, Air Asia, and maybe a few more small companies that maintains aircraft. So from my observation, most of these companies, they have enough manpower. Sometimes they have surplus manpower to maintain their own aircraft. Because I know some people, they have this license, but they are not employed by any airlines company. The seats are limited, and the airlines will make sure that the ones they train will get a job first. Then only if they have surplus place in their company, then they will take outsiders. That's why I say that it's a bit saturated. It pays handsomely, quite handsomely. We are paid less than the pilots, but we are paid more than most of my friends that is a degree holder. After you graduate, you will get 5,000, but as the years goes by, the increment is higher than most other jobs. The worst thing about this job is you could say that it tends to be repetitive actually. Usually it's the same thing that gets spoiled on the aircraft. So it's the same thing that we replace, the same thing that we check usually. But then again, if you were to say repetitive, I can say that all jobs are repetitive actually. Once you are good at it, then it kind of become repetitive. So if you want to have a job generally, so you have to be prepared to do the same thing all over again for the rest of your life. The best thing you can say about my job is you get to work with a very modern piece of technology, which is the airline. Every time they come up with a new aircraft, then the aircraft will become more and more modern. So it's quite cool. If you want to become an aircraft engineer, I can say that it's a very good career path for you to join. It pays well, but make sure that you entered a program that is under an airline, not you go and take the license on your own. Because like I said, the airline will try to promote the ones that they train rather than they take from outside, fresh graduate from outside.